My name is Maria Del Pico Taylor. I am a professor of piano at Temple University and the director of the Taubman Seminar, which happens once a year during the summer. The Taubman Seminar is one of the things that we have created in this school because it is a significant contribution to the health of the pianists in my studio and also to pianists who come from other sources because they want to learn more or because they have been injured and different other reasons. I was very fortunate to have met Dorothy Taubman at the very first piano festival that she presented in Rensselaerville, New York. I had heard a lot of stories about this legendary woman and I was intrigued by it. So I went, and I must say that I fell in love with her from the moment she walked up on the stage. She was vivacious, enthusiastic, brilliant, absolutely brilliant, and had a lot to say. I never forget her first phrase. Well, not the first, but the second or so. She said, in many fields of knowledge, we are very, very advanced. But in the field of piano technique, we still feel that we have it or we don't have it. If we have it, that is wonderful. If we don't have it, there is nothing that we can do about it. That, of course, was provocative. So I decided that I was going to sit on the first row every time and listen very carefully to see if she could actually prove that point. And she absolutely did. After 2 weeks, I was totally hooked. She was conceptual, organized, scientific, intelligent, musical, just an absolutely musical genius, I think. And at the end of the 2 weeks, I was completely convinced, and I decided to start studying with her in New York, traveled to New York every couple of weeks from that moment on until she died just a few years ago. The question of the Taubman technique that comes up all the time is, what is it all about? I do these lectures and conferences all over the world. I've done them all over Europe, in South America, various places and so on. And I usually like to find out what kind of an audience I'm dealing with. So I say something like, do you know the name of Dorothy Taubman? Yes, you know, hands go. And then I say, what do you know about her? Well, she's the one that does this. This rotation, and my response is, well, this is not rotation. This is an amorphous movement that has absolutely nothing to do with rotation, because rotation is a very specific, detailed movement that has to be done exactly right, or otherwise it doesn't work. And it doesn't originate on the wrist. It's actually a movement of the forearm. But the point of the matter is that I don't want people to think that everything is so complicated that you cannot learn anything about the Taubman technique unless you spend years and years. This is true. You have to have a person who is very experienced with the system, or with the program, I should say, teaching you. You have to have the initiative and the desire to learn and so on. But there are also some simple things that could be introduced almost at any time to anybody. For example, the concept of the in and out. In the concept of the in and out relates to the fact that we have black keys and white keys. And then we have short fingers and long fingers. So the long fingers, it's no problem when you're playing the white keys, but when once you begin to go into the black keys, it's a little bit more complicated because you understand that you don't have to stretch in order to reach a note. For example, if you take something as simple as one of the Bach minuets that we can teach to children. Most of the times you see children doing this thing and stretching because they cannot reach that note. But if you realize that the fingers can do the walking, it's no problem. So we move gradually. By the time we are at the F sharp, we're already there. The same thing happens, for example, on this minuet. Same thing, here is no problem. But here you see the children is struggling to get to that F sharp. But if you walk in gradually, there is no problem. So you can look at, for example, of course, people who teach beginners that want to learn to play something by ear, one of the most common moves that you see is this, twisting in order to get to that chord. You have twisting. But basically, if you just move in ever so slightly, there is no problem. actually easy and without any danger of injuring yourself by doing abnormal movements.